Are you looking to improve your health this new year? Well, take an eye-opening journey under the skin. Body Worlds 101 has just opened at the Health Museum along with Reclaimed Creations. And it's my pleasure to welcome Ella Homan. She is the Science Communication Specialist and she's joining us with more. Thank you so much for waking up with us.
Oh my gosh, thank you for having us.
I am very excited about this. These are huge exhibits. The Health Museum, a lot of people don't realize what a gem it is. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so we're the only museum that is dedicated to health in the United States. And I think we take a really unique approach to looking at health. You know, we often take our journey through life in these bodies for granted and really only think about it when we're ill. So really looking at what health is and what it means to us through different lenses, you know, through art, but also through science, I think is something that we do really well.
You really do, and it sticks with me, and it makes it not intimidating. I'm not gonna lie, biology was not my jam in school. I struggled with that, but you guys make it really approachable, and I always take it. I love the lab for the kids too.
Yeah, the That's lab my favorite. Is incredible.
It really yeah. is. But this is incredible, these two exhibits, so tell me about them.
Yeah, so we'll start with Body World. So Body Worlds 101, this is an exhibit that was created actually specially for our museum. So this particular array of specimens has never been seen before. So it's really cool. You walk through and it's basically a journey through what lies under the skin. Ooh. We don't often think about that.
No.
But you know, we've got these awesome pieces. There's one called the Nervous Man, where you can look at your whole nervous system. So your brain, your eyes, and all of these nerves that go through your body. And it's really quite humbling, honestly, to walk through yeah. and think of all these things that are happening in your body that you don't even think about, but they're happening every second of every single day. So it's incredible. And then we've got Reclaimed Creations, which yeah. is basically the intersection of art and science. Mm-hmm. So Sayaka Gans, she's a Japanese artist, created these fantastic sculptures out of found plastics and discarded plastics. And there's animal forms, there's a human form as well. And we basically look at, you know, how humans, we use plastic all the time. It's, I mean, it's everywhere you look, really. But it's done all of these awesome things for us, but how it might also be negatively impacting us. And we take a pretty deep dive into microplastics, which have been found in lots of different parts of the body. So
this is fascinating. It just oh, yeah. opened up, too. How long is it here for, both of these exhibits?
So they're here till fall. So I think it's till Labor Day, I want to say.
Okay, good. But you guys want to see them now. I think
Absolutely.
This is incredible to go and see. Tell everybody the pricing and where exactly you all are located, because when I moved here, I didn't even know we had a health museum, you know?
Yeah. So we're located right in the heart of the museum district, as we like to say. It's at 1515 Herman Drive, right opposite the Centennial Garden, so you can pair it with a lovely walk in the park. We're open 10 to 5 most days.
Okay.
We do open at 12 on Sundays, and we're open until 6 p.m. on Thursdays.
That's great.
Yeah.
Where can we go to get our tickets, our admission?
Yeah, so all of that information can be found online.
What is your favorite part about each one of these exhibits, would you say?
Body Worlds, I want to say it's just the sort of spooky, maybe kind of creepy aspect of it, but it's just so interesting. As someone, you know, with a background in biology, to be able to see these things that are usually hidden
yeah.
behind our skin, just being exposed is, you know, so fantastic. And honestly, for the Reclaimed Creations, my favorite part is this interactive table we have where we look at atoms, and you can actually build your own plastic polymers using carbon and hydrogen atoms. So that one's probably my favorite. That one's a lot of fun.
Oh my gosh, you make me excited about learning, and especially about learning with science.
Mm-hmm.
Tell everybody why the Health Museum is so special.
I just think it's special because we really take such a unique approach to something like health. Like I said at the beginning, we really often only think about our health when something goes wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So to really make a conscious effort to think about it, even when, you know, we're not ill, and to make these efforts to, you know, do healthier things for ourselves and learn about our bodies, I think is just really awesome.
And you have an event coming up too for Valentine's Day, right?
We do. That one's, I think, one of my favorites that we do in the year. It's called Heartstrings Unraveled. It's a Valentine's heart dissection and date night, which is exactly what it sounds like.
Wait,
actually.
You're dissecting a heart?
Yeah, so it's a dinner and then followed by a heart dissection. And we're actually doing one for Galentine's as well this year. So if you want to take your friends the day before Valentine's.
Maybe if you've been heartbroken.
Great way to process that, right?
Yeah.
Literally
just
cut through a heart.
Just get in there. I'm glad you eat before you do this.
That was intentional.
Okay, I'm kind of I may have to have you guys bring something in here.
Oh my gosh, yeah, we'd be
happy
to.
I want to get down and dirty.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Okay, because I didn't do well at biology. I only passed because Dr. Janch, I helped her plan her wedding.
Okay.
I did get mono junior year of high school.
Okay.
So, yeah. So I feel like you could teach me some more.
Absolutely.
I missed the dissection part.
And I think it's what's awesome about the dissections is you don't need to have like previous experience, right? We have like a doctor and a science educator there who talk you through it. So it
I
is
think that's
very
actually really cool. I'm very intrigued by this for sure. Speaking of health, there's something that really we need to help our community with, and it's our blood supply, especially from the winter storm. So we're going to have a live report from our own Seth Kovar, and again, check out all that the Health Museum has to offer over on their website and our website, cw39.com. We'll be with you after the break.